interrupt this full body workout for some breaking news. Looks like it's time to throw away those slim body waist trainers. Studies have now shown that not only is the hot ticket item a hoax, but there's no evidence to support that waist trainers help reduce your waist size. In other news, coronavirus...
Seriously?
Pay $5 for this thing. Kobe, stay. Pay $5 for this.
Okay guys, so we have to talk about the waist trainer. I see so many people wearing these things and I just don't understand why. So in this video, I'm going to give you three strong reasons on why not to wear a waist trainer. It's Michelle West here, and welcome back to my channel where I create videos to help inform, motivate, and inspire you to get up, move, and live a healthier life. If you're returning to my channel, welcome back. But if you're new to my channel and you love fitness-focused content, make sure you hit that subscribe button and also hit that bell so you know when I drop a new video. So in today's video, we are going to talk about the famous fitness fad, the waist trainer. Now, I know a lot of people wear waist trainers to target a certain area, to look a certain way, and to try to target weight loss in their belly. And I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but you don't need it. You don't need it. These things do not work. Honestly, I would rather you not wear one at all while you're working out. And in today's video, I'm gonna give you three strong reasons why not to wear a waist trainer. Now, before we get into the reasons, I wanna say that this information is not based off solely my opinion. This is based off of scientific research. So if I convince one person to not wear a waist trainer anymore or to not buy one, then I did my job today. Reason number one, waist trainers give off the illusion that you're holding and engaging your abdominal muscles when in actuality, you're not holding them at all. Now, if you've watched my previous video where I teach you how to engage your core properly, you'll remember that I say proximal stability equals distal mobility. And all in all, that decreases injury. Now, if you're wearing a waist trainer while you work out and you're not properly engaging your core, that means you're not giving your abs the strength that it needs for your activities of daily living. Bending and lifting, pushing and pulling, all of those things, you need to have a good base of support. So if you don't have a good base of support, you are increasing your chances for lower back injuries. All I'm trying to say is try your workout without the waist trainer. Don't make the process longer and harder for yourselves. If you take the waist trainer off now and you learn how to engage your core properly, you will see more progress in a faster time than you wearing a waist trainer and not having to engage your core. Reason number two, the idea of the waist trainer targeting belly fat because you sweat more in that area is a giant myth. More sweat does not equal more weight loss. Believe me, I sweat like a pig when I'm working out, but that doesn't mean I'm losing 10 pounds during my workout. It just means I'm a heavy sweater. So when you're wearing a waist trainer and you sweat more in your belly area, you're just losing water weight. Guess what's gonna happen when you replenish your body with that water by drinking a glass of water? You're going to gain that weight back. Losing weight and losing inches is all about caloric deficit. So if you're burning the proper amount of calories while you're working out, combined with less calories consumed in your diet, that is what targets weight loss. And a waist trainer is not going to help you burn more calories. It just doesn't work that way. Reason number three, it seems in the past couple of years that the hottest look to achieve is the small waist and big butt. Sure, I totally get it. But guys, you have to understand that target weight loss and target weight gain are completely impossible, and your body's gonna do what it does based purely off your genetics, and we cannot change that. So ideally what happens is when you're working out and you're losing weight, you're going to lose weight first where you gained weight last. I hope that made sense. You're gonna lose weight first where you gained weight last. And for me, when I personally started to see myself lose weight, I lost weight first in my face. As I continued to lose weight, I then saw weight loss in my arms, then my legs, and then my butt. And that's when I was like, no, not my butt. I have to remember all of the stories that my mother used to tell me when she was younger, that she had no boobs and no butt. Genetics, guys. All in all, the last place that I started to see weight loss was my belly. And this is gonna change from person to person. So if we know now that target weight loss is impossible and it's based purely off your genetics, then what exactly is this targeting? Also, guys, let's be really real. Those extreme hourglass figures that you see on celebrities are usually not obtained by weight loss and exercise. They're obtained by surgery, unless you are blessed with that shape. So what do you want? You want to live a healthier life, or do you want surgery? In conclusion, weight loss and losing inches is a process, and it's going to take time. It is possible to lose belly fat, but a waist trainer is not going to make that process even faster. All you need is proper diet and good exercise to see results. So I encourage you to love your body, love the process of becoming healthier, and get rid of the waist trainer because you don't need it. If you like this video and learned anything new, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Also, leave it down in the comments about your opinions on waist trainers. You obviously know my opinion, but I would love to hear your opinion as well. Thank you all so much for watching this video, and I hope to see you on the next one. Bye.